Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Bastion Slot, and welcome for the very first time to Pine View Aquatic Park. This is a 5-animal aquatic park based on the new Aquatic Pack, oddly enough, where we're going to build an exhibit for each of the 5 new animals. Starting off today, of course, with the King Penguin. This is going to be a fairly chill enclosure, kind of getting to grips with a lot of the new things, you know, the new the faux rocks we need a lot of and stuff like that, the new staggered waterfall, we're going to use that as well, some very cool stuff. And what we're doing here is, of course, building some underwater viewing as well. Actually, I had the idea of combining the underwater viewing for the next 2 enclosures, so the penguins today and the seals tomorrow. That's right. 2 days in a row. All 5 episodes of this aquatic park will be going up this week. We're going to do one each after the other days in a row, so tomorrow will be the seals. And the idea really was to have you walk down into this little covered enclosure area and you'd be able to see the underwater enclosure for the penguins and the underwater enclosure for the seals on either side. I thought that was a nice idea. What we're using here is the new double strength, or the thick glass, I think it's called. Thick with 2 C's, obviously. And basically it just adds a nice kind of stony and bronze kind of look to the glass. The actual glass itself doesn't really change very much, but, you know, the barrier itself looks pretty nice. You would have seen it in my video earlier today if you checked that out. So really just getting the basics done at the moment, just kind of like laying out the groundwork for the underwater viewing area, making sure that all works okay. If you're going to do something like this, my main suggestion would be constantly check to see if your water is still working, because the water's a little bit finicky, it will stop working at times. So if you change something massively in the area, just put your water back in, try it out again, take it out, put it in, take it out. And go from there. So one of the main ideas I had for this exhibit in terms of design was to have a staggered waterfall using the new staggered waterfall tools, but one that you could walk through and one that the penguins would walk through as well. So that's kind of what we're building here. These are the new faux rocks and they are incredible. If you didn't see my item video on this earlier, you'll have missed me gushing about them. I love these rocks. You're going to see a lot of these rocks in the next 3 videos, including this one, and probably in the 2 after that, if I'm totally honest, because they make me very happy. They really do. So just kind of sorting out the barrier now. It's a little bit of a finicky thing to do, especially with the water there. As I say, take the water out, move your barrier, put the water back in, blah, blah, blah. But yeah, the idea was to have a waterfall that the penguins could walk through. I thought that was quite a nice little cheeky idea. There's not really a big theme or hook for this. Those of you who've watched me play Planet Zoo know I like to have my themes and my hooks. For this episode, I kind of tried to keep it fairly low-key and more like an exhibit you would see in an actual zoo, which is, you know, a rarity for me, really. Yeah, these things are great. These faux rocks are really cool. They don't look fantastic right now, but you can colour them in. You can choose the colouring on them, so we want to make them, of course, like an Arctic kind of style. And that's what we'll be doing in a little bit. Until then, there's going to be a lot of rocks. So just get used to that nice and early. I don't know what I'm doing here, quite frankly. Something's going terribly wrong. I'm just trying to duplicate them and move them to the other sides because I'm, you know, lazy. Cough. Having a little look at how... there's a couple of really nice pre-made items I don't use. Actually, I do use one of them, but not in the actual enclosure. But it's nice to take a look at them just for an idea about how other people are building, basically. And there is our lovely waterfall. Really simple to use, much simpler than the existing tools, and it does kind of look better. There's only 3 of them at the moment, but between those 3 shapes, you can kind of get everything you'd want to get anyway. It's still kind of hard to build massive waterfalls, which is what I would really like to do, but we'll get there. God, I love these rocks. You just wait until it all comes together, I'm telling you. But right now all I'm trying to do is kind of stack them around the waterfall just to make the waterfall look more like a natural formation rather than just a random blob, basically. Oh, I was meant to cut this out. There you go. That's me googling about King Penguins. The idea was to check out their habitat, where they would primarily live, and therefore deduce what kind of plants I could use in the enclosure. I did limit myself a lot. I used very, very little foliage, okay, I promise you. Here I'm just kind of marking out the boundary of the edge. I actually tried this exhibit multiple times, so it was kind of hard work for me. I kept making it too big, just way, way, way too big. So this one I was, as you can see, kind of determined to bring it in size-wise, because that way, penguins aren't a gigantic animal, unless they're that penguin from the end of Endless Ocean 2, which was an absolute monster. But I kind of just wanted to bring it in so that you could always see them, basically. And this here is the new mural item. As you can see, it does kind of link together if you kind of just stick them one after the other. Really nice kind of thing you'd expect to see in a zoo. It's got that kind of aquarium kind of feel to it, you know. Did it link up? Oh, it's beautiful. Look at that. Stunning. So we're just going to use that as like a backdrop. A lot of that's going to get covered with rock, but it's so you can leave gaps in the rock and there's still like a nice Arctic theme going on behind them, which I think is always a pretty cool thing. I couldn't get the light to work. The light in this game doesn't make sense, by the way. Like, the sun is never, like, on the right. Like, I don't know, the sun does not travel in a purely normal direction. I'm convinced on this by this point in time. Anyways, more muraling. Just using it as, like, a ensconcing the whole thing. And I thought we'd stick some penguins in there every now and again. Not the mural signs, apparently. Apparently I was not on board with those. But the penguins, yeah. And some lights, of course, as well. One thing you'll see throughout this playthrough, less so today, but particularly in the next two videos, I've spent a lot of time focusing on lighting, and I may as well talk about it now because all I'm going to be doing is putting down rocks for the next 20 minutes. I really wanted the entire park to look good at nighttime. If anything, it actually looks better at nighttime. Also, that's really cute. It's like a little penguin house entrance thing, so I wanted to build that up just a little bit so it looks like a little area the penguin could go and hang out. Anyways, I really spent a lot of time making sure everything looks good at dark. You know, there's lampposts everywhere, there's lights in all the enclosures, stuff like that. And that will come to fruition really well in tomorrow's video, but also in part in tonight's video as well, as you will hopefully see. That's my favorite rock, by the way. You're going to see that one a lot. Aquatic Faux Rock 3 is king of the faux rocks. It's the most natural looking one. I find it's very handy with this kind of thing. Like, that doesn't look great on its own like that, you know, if you just looked at the threes. But once you've got those in there, that's when you start to add stuff around them. It's a really good, like, base, and then, you know, you've got your buttery biscuit base, and you start to sort of ladle things on top. I'm really not good with my words today. I don't know why I've just said ladle. But you start to put things on top, and it kind of breaks the patterning up, and, yeah, it kind of all comes together. Little cheeky entrance. Wait, there's actually a new barrier entrance. I think it's new, but it's like a glass one. I don't think that's been in the game before, unless I'm crazy. It could have been in the game, to be fair. I was really excited at this point, because there is the basic bones of the enclosure, right? But the rocks are still the same color they always were. And I realized that some of them were grouped up awkwardly. So I was kind of like resisting the temptation to change them all into the Arctic rock quite yet. I wanted it to be this big transformation moment kind of thing, you know? After I spent half an hour making sure they're in the same bloody group. Just put them in the same group, folks. It makes your life so much easier, I promise. Especially if you're going to end up colouring them all at once, which is exactly what we end up doing. But yeah, that's the basic bones of the exhibit right there. I think at this point it's just making it look cool, basically. Cool things are cool, as they say. And of course we're going to work on the underwater bit. We're going to do this, the path thing. We're going to do absolutely everything. I'm really excited about this zoo. Hopefully you guys at home are as well. Obviously, it's been a while since we actually built a full zoo and got to the end. But with the DLC, having 5 animals, all of it with a really strong theme as well, I've kind of found it a lot easier to just build, you know, and just focus in on it. And it's not like this massive project kind of crippling me. It's doable, which is nice. Anyways, building up our underwater bit. We're going to use this as well. This is new. This is the new stained wood. Or what it's called. Yep. You're not really going to see much of this, but it's just so there's a solid backdrop there, so it looks a little bit more realistic, I suppose. I'm going to make that in a nice shade of blue at some point soon. It'll happen. It's going to be lovely anyway. You should be very excited. Just finagle all that together. Lovely stuff. Yeah, just wanted it to seem a little bit more solid, a little bit more professionally made, I suppose. As per usual, my ordering for how I build things is incredibly haphazard. I think, what do I want to build this second? Let's go do that. Oh, different. Let's go do that. There's no rhyme or reason. It's just whatever I'm in the mood for. Yeah, stained wood's quite nice as well. Wanted to sink a little bit of stone in the gap between... It's always nice to have double fences, I find, in a zoo, because I think that's more natural looking. Just wanted to sink some stone between, particularly the fence and the barrier, essentially. Do my little stack there. Just because I think that looks a little bit more, I don't know, like an actual zoo, I suppose. Can't have any of that filthy grass nonsense going on. No, senorita, no. Just fill in the gaps a little bit there. There's going to be a lot of stones today, just so you're aware. I mean, this already looks quite nice. This could be like a non-Arctic penguin habitat. It could be like a rockhopper thing. It might be a little bit too grassy for the rockhoppers, but you know, the general vibe is okay. But we're going to make it brisk. That's also another one of the faux rocks. We've got like a staircase kind of thing, which I believe the penguins do use. Pretty sure I've seen my penguins use it. You'll see that in a little bit anyway. We'll of course spend some time with the gwyns at the end of this video. But I made a mistake here. I added the water too early, and when I removed the water, and this is why I was saying this earlier, if I remove that water right now, I can't add it back in the same way because something is blocking it. If you remember the very first zoo we did when the game came out, the Thailand zoo, we had the same thing, as in I removed the water to put some stuff in and I could never add it back ever again, and it made me very, very sad. So please heed my warning and just constantly check what you're doing with the water. And like, I messed up here again, so I wasn't able to change the land under the water anymore at this point. We have to kind of, that's a good thing about the rocks. Rocks can change the formation of the landscape even when, you know, the water is stopping you from doing so, basically. So to that end, we're going to use 10 billion of them, as you can see. But there's a really nice selection. You can change the colour and the colouring of the cracks. You can do basically everything. I want even more of these. I really hope this is something they stick with, because okay, yeah, the rocks we have in the game are great, but these ones are just better, basically, because we can choose the colouring. You know, it makes them much more malleable and adaptive, which is a really cool feature in a game all about creativity, so. But yeah, they can't quite do everything. You know, they're not mossy, for example. Never going to be able to recreate that directly, but other than that, they're pretty great. Sorry, I'm going to talk a lot about these rocks. I love the rocks. Time to get stony and chilly. There we go, make sure that all works. They just lift right off that lovely stuff, making sure it's all together. Trying to anyway, and there we go. For just temporarily, I was messing with the idea of making a Mars-themed habitat, okay? Don't judge. And there we go. Instantly, we've changed. I mean, that's my point. Look how instantly the whole tone of the enclosure changed from this grassy, warm, knoll kind of thing to this frozen Arctic wasteland. I mean, instant! That's the beauty of these rocks, and we could change it back if we wanted to. It's just so adaptive and malleable. I really, really like it. There's a little gap there. There's a little gap there on the left. You can see it by the waterfall. I do fix that. Okay, I promise. It does get fixed. Anyways, just fixing the water, making sure there's a nice little bit of splishy splashy at the bottom. These are official terms, by the way, splishy splashy. And for the actual enclosure, that is, it's not a million miles away from being done. I was pretty happy with it at this point. Like I said, I was trying to not go too over the top. I just wanted a nice big enclosure the penguins could actually explore, that it looked good from the outside, it looked good at night time. Yeah, that's about it. It's not too much else to it. I do bring in some plants, okay, because I have to, because my soul burns if I don't, but I did resist. I was very, very, very contained. I think there's two of these little bushes in the whole thing. I liked the idea of a little bit of this southern portion being a little bit grassier. There's no grass in the north portion at all. So if you imagine the exhibit stretched onto the south, you know what I'm like. I like my exhibits to be like a slice of the real world to an extent. So if you imagine it stretches out to the south a little bit further, that would be more mainland. It would get a little bit warmer, a little bit more, less icy, essentially. So there's a couple more plant life around there, there's a couple more like long grass areas, blah blah, but not much. And then the top end, the north, the enclosure, it's pure ice, pure snow, there's no plant life at all. Those are our new enrichment items, penguins. I've never actually seen them do it, but they should dive under them and pop out the middle and hop on. And that of course is our new underwater feeder as well. Somewhere in there, and now it's time for even more rocks. So I realised, of course, we're using faux rocks. Why not mix and match the colours up a little bit? So we've got this medium grey, and then I added in a lighter one, a much more snowy kind of one. And just having those two different colours, I think, mixes things up and makes it a little bit more interesting to look at and realistic, essentially. And it's something I never used to do at all. Even with real rocks, I never used to do it. It's something I've had to train myself to start doing now. Now it's time for the lights. So, So, this is my little underwater feeder. The idea is that you can go down here at nighttime and you should be able to see the feeder. And I really wanted it to be blue. I wanted you to walk down into this darkened, enclosed area and there'd be blue lights everywhere. And you could look to the left, you could see one feeder. Look to the right, you could see the other. That was the idea. I'm going to light the enclosure in general with the new aquatic light. I don't know what it's called, but aquatic light, potentially. And like I said, I wanted a roof for this section. Now, this is the one bit, if you're watching this today, I still haven't fixed this. So, this roof is going to cover both the seal and the penguin viewing area, right? As you can see. It still looks basically like this. I've changed the colouring up now with the seal one a little bit to make it half and half. So, it's kind of half Arctic, half more seal appropriate. But it's very flat. I feel like there should be something on top of it. Something quite large, but at this point in time, I don't know what that is. I still haven't figured that out. It's like the last thing in my zoo to this point that I'm not totally happy with. There should be something in the middle there. I'm thinking like a ship. I think that'd be quite a cool theming item to have, just like a ship sitting on there. But we'll see. Anyways, throwing some lights down underwater because otherwise you can't see. Basically, you can't see in the daytime at all. It's even worse. But I did realize the water was a little bit dirty, a little bit murky. So gone ahead and changed that setting, and added a water filter system as well. But you can see better at nighttime if you've got good lights, and you can make lights turn on permanently, which means you can actually increase your daytime visibility as well, which is pretty cool. Likewise, in the exhibit itself, light up the wooden things that the penguins don't bloody use in a way. But I just wanted the key points of the enclosure to be highlighted, I suppose is the point. It's where the waterfall is highlighted as well. Wanted a little sign here, don't think it ever quite worked out. Oh, because I couldn't customize it. It wasn't working for some reason. Just the sign stopped working. They do work now, but temporarily they broke. But yeah, look at that. Doesn't that look really nice? That underwater viewing area. Imagine the penguins swooping down there to pick up the fish. Not that they ever do, because there's never any bloody fish there, but that's... it's neither here nor there. I'm going to add a little bit more rocks to there, I think. It needs a little bit of spicing up in detail. Otherwise, I'm pretty happy with it. I like being able to see into the cavernous distance and all the lights in the distance. I like that a lot. Now for the guest bit. Not a lot of focus on the guests in this zoo, which is one of the beautiful things about doing a mini zoo for me, is I don't have to build, like... a restaurant and a hotel, because screw them, who cares? So, got a little new, these are new aquatic street lamps, really, really like these. And a little gull on there, because why the hell not, basically. And a couple of, that's like a sleeping thing that they can use. Do I keep that? No, didn't think so. Some little items here and there, food trays, all of which are in completely the wrong place, because they can't be used. same with the mirror mobile. But yeah, it's coming together. Well done me. And as they say, lots of faux rock. It's just, it's so good. It's so good. for reference sake, this was about a 2 hour, 30 minute build. I think this is times 7 speed? 6 speed? Something like that. It might be just over 2 hours. Which is medium out of the 3 builds I've done so far. Tomorrow's one is a 4 hour build, so prepare yourselves. I wanted to do something in the middle of the path. I've started to use the thicker paths. You'll notice this. Like, that's a 10 right there. I just advise that in general. People should use the thick paths. It gives you more room to do little things like this. My little happy dancing penguin statues. I just wanted an introduction area, essentially. So, that's going to eventually say penguin path. I don't think, again, it works right now because the game has decided to hate me at this point in time. But it will forgive me very soon. And penguin path will get its name. Stagger some rocks in there, so the sign looks like it's kind of supported, basically. There we go. Penguin Path. Might come up with another name. I'm not sure what it would be quite yet, but might come up with something else. Like was over here, this is going to be our little education sign area kind of thing. It's nice building things into the path and into the fence and just kind of breaking up the monotony a little bit every now and again. It's probably my weakest part of my zoo building in general. It's something I know that I don't do very often and that other zoo builders do, and it makes the zoo feel more like an actual zoo, you know? So it's something I want to start to focus on a little bit more. And this is not a particularly good example of it either, but it is what it is. There we go. Even got a supporting structure. Just attention to detail, telling you folks, telling you. Good. Right. And there's a seal prepped for tomorrow. You know, so penguins on the left, because as you go down, that's where the penguins are. And seals on the right. The gull has to appear in every enclosure at least once, I've determined. Now, the gull is my my mascot, essentially. It's going to appear in every single enclosure I ever build. A little bit more lights. Again, trying to push that blue colour just because I thought it was cool, basically. I'm really excited about the nighttime in this park. It's going to look so good. You just wait till the next two videos. Right, well, apparently that's it. Let me just try to pause right at the end there. There you go. So that's a good view of it at nighttime. Like I say, it's pretty low-key in general. It looks better when we get in there, though. I'm going to release about 20 penguins into that enclosure now, so stick around and spend some time with our penguins. Hope you enjoyed. I'll see you in a second. Hello, folks. For the very first time, I know you've just heard me for 20 minutes, but for me, this is the first time I've actually said words to you on our new park build. Hello, gorgeous. I love them so much. Really, what we're going to do for the next 5-10 minutes is just observe our penguins. I'm going to bring you the exhibit in both daytime and nighttime. You may have seen in that video in the time-lapse we just did, a lot of time was spent on the nighttime, on the lighting in this exhibit, but in particular the next two exhibits, I would say. But we're just going to hang out with our penguins, basically. I've brought in 20 or so of them. I've made sure the did a little bit of testing to make sure the exhibit does kind of link together in all the paths. Oh. They're fighting. Don't fight. It's like he's slapping him on the ass. Good hustle, buddy. Good hustle. We don't have any, no pregnancies or anything yet. Hopefully in future videos I will bring you some babies. Now, I have at this point in time done two other exhibits in this park. We're doing all five animals in this zoo, as I've mentioned. But I have to try to hide those. You're not allowed spoilers. So we're only facing in this direction. But yeah, we're just going to spend a little time with our penguins at the end, basically. It is a very low-key enclosure. I really wanted to just get used to, say, the staggered waterfalls again, and the faux rocks in particular, and just get used to building exhibits and enjoying myself, basically. The next two habitats are a little bit more themed, shall we say, in the way that I would usually build something. So if you've seen this one, you're like, yes, finally, Besson sort of stopped doing stupid things with his exhibit design. Well, I'm afraid that didn't really stick. Although the next one is pretty cool. Come back tomorrow for that. That's our seal enclosure. How are we doing over here? I love that they're up here as well. I didn't think they'd be able to get on here, but they've managed it. I don't think they'll get on here, of course, but... Oh, can't see that. The more I can get them... Oh, I love that. So if we nip down here, you can see it's really quite a cavey kind of system. The idea is that, you know, sometimes the penguins will swim over, sometimes they'll swim under, they'll swim around the bend around here as well. I just want to see them going in different directions and doing different things. If we come down here... Little preview there. That's tomorrow's enclosure. I may as well talk about this now, though. The idea is, of course, you walk down here and you've got both underwater exhibits visible. The penguins on the left and the seals on the right, which is something I've never actually done before, so I'm really happy about that. I will say this looks a lot more interesting than this. I think we need to bring some rocks in to the penguin enclosure. Meow. I also need to make sure they can get some food, which I'm a little apprehensive about right now, if I'm honest. Any chance the food tray got fed? Nope, doesn't look like it. I don't know what the keeper's doing. Oh well. They're just so much fun to spend time with. The noises, the anime, the waddle they do. Look at him. Meow. Because why not, basically? They come and hang out with the bubbles over here, and they will actually... I really like this habitat. It looks like an actual habitat you see at a zoo, you know? Which isn't something I do very often, so it's nice to mix it up every now and again. That looks a little bit bizarre there. Might have gone a little bit much on the neck stretching. Anyways, yeah, folks, that is our penguin habitat. Nothing, as I say, nothing particularly special theming-wise or anything. It's pretty standard zoo penguin habitat, I'd say. But it's nice and it's fun to mess around with the rocks and... Yeah, I really enjoyed it, and the penguins themselves are absolutely awesome. So, there you go, there's a penguin path. Okay, there's a spoiler for tomorrow. I built a lighthouse. I'm very proud of it. I'm just saying. Although it looks a little topsy-turvy now, but I'm still very proud of it. And you'll see that in tomorrow's video. As the penguin emerges from the mist. They're all really liking hanging down. Oh, it's because the fish is here. I suspect my guy, my keeper, can't get over here. I might try to slip a doorway in there, perhaps, but it's not a big deal. They'll come over here, they'll eat, and then they'll head off into the rest of the park, basically. Okay, well, thank you so much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. This is what I'm going to do in these little bits in the future, more is than we ever did in the past. It's just showcasing animals, having fun in their habitats, more than anything else. That really should be the focus, I reckon. So, hopefully you really enjoyed this build. As I say, this week is Planet Zoo week. Tomorrow we're going to be back with the seals, the day after the terrapins, and then the only two I've not done so far, which is the otters and the caimans, will be on Friday and Saturday. Check out the playlist down below in the description for more Aquatic Pack stuff. All of my videos on this are going to be linked in that playlist, and you can follow that playlist specifically. Subscribe to the channel if you're new and you enjoyed the build. Hit the like button as well if you did. That would be cool beans. Thumbs up. You know, it's a bit of a throwback this, where, you know, DLCs comes out and we're just hammering it and building a zoo, and we're gonna have a good time. It's going to be cool. Hope you enjoyed. Thank you so much for joining me. Cheers, much love. And from me and the penguins, say goodbye. Strutting along. A little bit of a swagger on that penguin. Well, from me and the penguin, who's just swagging along, I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye. I just realised I didn't actually show you the enclosure at night, so a very quick little bonus bit here. Move you back. Try to take a thumbnail. Yeah, I kind of kept this one pretty chill. I actually went back and dimmed some of the lights since you last saw them in the time-lapse, because they were a little bit on the intense side. Yeah, I really put a lot of focus on the lighting this time. You'll see it in particular with the next few enclosures, but nothing particularly special here, but I think it looks quite nice. It's pleasant. And all the key parts have kind of lit up. I made sure these two were both lit up here. The waterfall, of course, has been lit up, and then some brighter lights over here at the start as well. How do you feel about the lights in the enclosure, Bobby? Bobby loves them. He absolutely bloody loves them. So there you go. Penguin enclosure, penguin path. Done.